I'm not getting nothing to pimp me. I believe what I speak. And if you need proof, just keep watching. While you're standing, open your Bible to 2 Chronicles chapter 7. And let's also make sure we acknowledge all those that will be viewing and listening to this message across the nations through all our media outlets. So give God praise for our listening audience right now. Come on, give God praise. We're becoming one of the most listening to religious broadcasts on Sunday mornings. So we give God praise. Prayer still works. Prayer still works. While your Bibles are now open to 2 Chronicles chapter 7, we'll begin reading with verse number 11. Prayer still works. And I pray you're praying for your man of God in a season of transitioning in which God is reshaping and remolding and reassigning. I pray you're praying for me as I pray for you.
All right.
The word of God records, we're reading with verse number 11. The word of God says, when Solomon had finished the temple of the Lord and the royal palace, he had succeeded in carrying out all he had in mind to do in the temple of the Lord and in his own palace. The Lord appeared to him at night and said, I have heard your prayer and have chosen this place for myself as a temple of sacrifice. Verse 13, when I shut up the heavens, some versions say, if I shut up the heavens, so there will be no rain or command locusts to devour the land or send a plague among the people. Verse 14, our closing verse, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and heal their land. Take your seat, tell your neighbor, prayer still works. Prayer still works. Here in the text, the Lord is giving instructions to Solomon on how to pray for positive results. Look at me if you will and say positive results. Because we've been praying, but we have not been receiving positive results. So God is giving Solomon personal instructions on how to pray for positive results. And this prayer was not a personal prayer for Solomon, but it was a national prayer of repentance for a nation. And that's where the strain is on your man of God. God keeps speaking to me about the nation when I'm trying to just build a church. God keeps putting on my heart about a community while I'm trying to build a church. And God keeps inspiring me to build a community. So it's created a strain within my own inner being. How do I build the church and the community and speak to the nation at the same time? But God is giving Solomon wisdom on how to speak and pray over a nation that has been rebelling against God.
Yeah.
Watch this. Right. Recent headlines in America. Because as God is giving Solomon instructions to pray for the repentance of a nation, many of you, none of you probably could argue with this. If we ever need to pray for a nation, if we ever need to be in a season and a time of prayer, it's in America right now. America shouldn't be worried about Democrats and Republicans right now. America should be worried about repenting and returning back to God. Recent headlines in America. Listen to this. 31-year-old black man shot his mother 8 times in the back, cuts out her heart, then stands over her dead body and pleasures himself. And you still don't think we should be praying? Ben Carson, a black candidate for the president of the United States of America, says black lives matter is hurting America, and black folks should shut up and not focus on police killing us, on mass incarceration, or the fact that schools are being closed in our communities while prisons are being built for our little boys and little girls. And then he has the audacity to state Obamacare is equal to modern day slavery, when Obamacare is trying to provide health care for all Americans. And if I recall, history tells me that slavery made it okay to rape a black woman. Slavery made it okay to beat a black man. Slavery made a black man no more than property to be passed from hand to hand. And you got the audacity as a black man wanting to be in the White House to tell me that Obamacare is equal to slavery, and we still don't think we should be praying? When Donald Trump can look you in the face, black man and brown man and woman, and tell you you don't mean la-di-da to him, and you still say he's the leading candidate on the Republican side, when a man can look you in your face and tell you you don't mean nothing, America, we need to pray.
Amen.
Jesus.
Preach, Pastor Tucker.
When I get a phone call early in the morning, and Brandon Braggs, 29-year-old black man, has been shot down in the Greens Point community, leaving 3 sons behind, which adds to the list of funerals just this year I've done for murder victims. I gotta really sit down and think about how many I've done just this year. And you still don't think that we should be praying? You want to have a praise party, but you don't want to pray. You want to act like God, but not talk to God.
Preach, Pastor.
See, watch this. You in your Bible?
Yes.
See, I just want to come in and make you shout, so you'll get up better, so we can do better. But the Lord won't let me do that. So I just got to be what the Lord called me to be. Biblical history records Solomon as being very wise and wealthy. Now, how many of you would like that to be your call? People say, he's very wise, he's very wealthy. She's very wise, she's very wealthy. Well, Solomon was both wise and wealthy. Because I know a bunch of wise folks is broke, and I know a bunch of wealthy folks is unwise. But Solomon was wise and wealthy at the same time.
God Almighty, yes, we give you glory.
We give you glory.